Hey guys, it's Crystal Ann Compton, and you are about to watch a really cool video, which is a conversation that I had with channel and medium Vanessa Claire in my podcast, Life Magnetics. And the full version of the podcast is ready and available for you to listen to wherever you catch your podcasts. But in this clip, we're actually having a conversation about social media and how it is that social media isn't just happening in the third dimension. It's actually happening in a multi-dimensional way. And we talk about why this is powerful, but also really, really dangerous. And this is actually a topic that I should probably do a deep dive in a longer video, and maybe I will. But for now, check out these concepts and ask yourself, are you consciously or unconsciously creating a future you really want or a future that you don't want? And by the way, I'm also going to be dropping the full video version of the podcast later this week on YouTube. And please remember to like and subscribe and do all the social media things. It really helps me across platforms and I truly appreciate it. All right, let's get into it. I've been asking folks, especially intuitive folks like you, what your impression might be for 2022 and beyond. Of course, here in the United States, 2021. Things are a little jacked up, Vanessa, I got to tell you. It's a little crazy out here. And I know people are really, really impacted by what they're seeing as reality. And we were having a really cool conversation about social media and 4D before we actually started recording. But how do you think we move in this energy from 2021 into 2022? And what do you kind of see coming up for us if you want? And if you want to pull a card, you could do that too. However you want to comment, if you do.
Okay, so feeling into this, we kind of talked about it a little bit, and it feels like it might get worse before it gets better. But the other thing to that, the other feeling with it is, I think it's actually really, really good. Number one, all this light is being shown on the shadow work that we as a collective need to be doing. So that's number one. And number two, I think a lot of people are going to get really clear about who they are, what their values are. And I really actually think that this is a potential for all of us to look at ourselves and get clear about what our values are, not necessarily like be mean to other people, but being, no, this is who I am. These are my boundaries.
Boundaries. Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. So I think it could have a lot of good in it.
Always. There's always a polarity, right? And I think within America, we tend to think, oh, this is an American problem. All the things are, but it's happening all over the world. Like all of your major countries are having turmoil, divisiveness, mm-hmm. clash of values, and trying to create a path forward, which is why I think the issue of social media is actually really important, because one thing we all have in common is our connection points in social media. And when we're connecting with others via social media, it truly is happening here in the third dimension. I'm looking at my phone, I'm talking to Vanessa, but it's also happening in the ether, in the etheric realms. You'd call these the astral realms. And dimensionally speaking, it's happening in the fourth dimension, which already is a dimension somewhat of chaos. It's a portal mm-hmm. dimension, mm-hmm. but it's where you find ghosts. It's where you find the recently deceased, the dreamers. And there's a lot going on there.
All the voices that I was hearing, all that chaotic.
Right.
Yeah.
I describe it as like the bar scene in Star Wars with all the weird aliens just partying.
Yes.
I don't know what's going on here. It's a little nuts though. So it's like, it's a lot like that, but we're having that interaction in 3D, but also 4D. And the thing to note about that is that is a creative landscape.
Yes.
Your thoughts become things much more rapidly than in 3D. There's a process we go through. It takes a while to manifest mm-hmm. here mm-hmm. due to time and space and such. But in 4D, there's no restraint there. So whatever we're thinking in 4D, we're also crystallizing in 3D. And so what's happening on the planet, I believe, is as a result of us hanging out in 4D via social media and otherwise, and just being absolutely toxic. I mean, just defaulting to toxic, defaulting to not believing in somebody, defaulting to negativity, and also agreements, right?
Agreements.
Mm-hmm. Scrolling your timeline, and that friend who's going off about something nuts, you know, maybe politically, maybe spiritually. We just send a little like, though. Well, I love her. I'm going to like it. I'm going to agree to that. I'm not going to call it out. I'm not going to have a boundary. I'm not going to point my interest away from it. I'm going to agree to that. And in doing so, you activate a powerful spiritual universal law, which is when you and I agree on something, we compel our Father, our Creator, to do it.
Yes. Yes.
Let's talk about this in 2022. This is like my big thing. What are we agreeing on collectively?
Yeah, we have an opportunity to really like change and shift that to agree on things that are good for the world and uplift the world instead of the chaos.
The separation. Yes, we have an opportunity to consciously agree and therefore consciously create, because we're creating now. By our default throwaway agreements that we're making out of integrity. And it's more laziness and non-presence than it is intentionally agreeing to trashy concepts and therefore creating more trash. It's more apathy. It's like, oh, okay. And it's connecting into somewhat vitriolic, angry, constantly witch hunty kind of energy and participating in it and therefore growing it. And so, yeah, I don't see that ending anytime soon. So I'm going to co-sign what you just said. I do think it's going to be worse before it's better. Do you have a sense as to when it might start to get better up on this planet? Okay. Up in here.
Okay. Let me feel into this. So actually, for me, it feels like around the 2025 is what's coming to me, when things are going to start shifting and feeling really starting to change in a productive way.
I think 2025, it's going to be like this. Wind's changing a little bit.
Yeah.
I can feel something shifting, changing. But then 2027, 2028. End of this decade, like actual fundamental shifts that are changing our lives will take place. That's what I sense too. It's interesting because so many people are like, oh, it's gonna be great. No, it's gonna be so good. No, let's just call a thing a thing. I mean, we got some work to do, right?
We have some work to do for sure. And let's get intentional. Let's get intentional and let's bring in the love and let's figure out, let's get solution oriented.
The Lightshine Development Circle is a sacred place for spiritual seekers to practice giving and receiving readings. The circle is open to all psychics, oracle card readers, mediums, channels, energy healers, Akashic Records readers, and any other type of spiritual practitioner who offers their service via a reading style format. If you're ready to awaken your gifts and talents and fine-tune your intuitive abilities, we'd love to have you in the circle.